The world is losing ground in the fight to end child labor. That's according to the United Nations as the International Labor Organization releases its latest report on the practice. The ILO says the number of child laborers has increased to 160 million in 2020 from 152 million in 2016. This means one in 10 children are working and millions more are at risk due to the pandemic.
People have resort to child labor almost as a survival strategy. And our estimations show that unless we act to stop it, we could see a further increase in until the end of 2022, of some 9 million in child labor. This would take us further in the wrong direction. But it's not inevitable. If we do the right things, if we invest in the fight against child labor, invest in social protection and income support.
We urge countries to expand income support measures like child benefits to get children back into school where they belong and to invest in programs that prevent and protect them from being exploited. It's time to get back on track.
The UN has made 2021 the International Year for the Elimination of Child Labor. It says urgent action is needed to meet a goal of ending the practice by year 2025. News overseas now. It's been weeks since Israel and Hamas agreed to a ceasefire, ending 11 days of bloodshed, while the world leaders continue to discuss how to end the decades-long conflict permanently. It's the children of Gaza who continue to suffer. More in this report.
It's been 3 weeks since Susie Ishkentana was pulled from the rubble of her house in Gaza, destroyed by an Israeli airstrike. Her mother and four siblings are under the rubble. The six-year-old girl has barely spoken since, except to ask for her family, who were killed that day. Susie and her father are now living with her uncle, who said she barely eats, doesn't sleep well, and doesn't play.
الحكي خفيف صار عندها يعني كانت أنعمها يعني ودائما هي عندي في البيت كانت وأنا عندهم.
She doesn't speak a lot. I'm her uncle, and she used to stay at my home a lot. She used to speak more to be very active. She was a naughty girl, but after their home was hit and her mother was killed, the girl doesn't talk a lot. Doesn't play a lot, and she screams whenever people reach out to her, even myself, her uncle, whom she used to spend a lot of time with. She screams when I get close to her.
Half of young people in Gaza, around 500,000 children, could be in need of psychological support. That's according to officials from the UN Children's Fund, UNICEF, who say 11 days of fighting in May between the enclave's Hamas rulers and Israel has left children traumatized. Susie's home was struck in a wave of Israeli attacks on Gaza City on May 16th. Gaza health officials say those attacks killed 42 people, including 10 children. Israel said those attacks targeted an underground tunnel system used by Hamas to transport weapons, and that the houses collapsed as a result of the tunnel network crumbling. Psychologists have paid Susie regular visits to help her process her trauma. Psychiatrists say depression and insecurity are the most common psychological issues they see here. Around half of Gaza's population of 2 million are under 18. Many carry the trauma of three previous wars and several other violent conflicts fought between Israel and Gaza militant groups since 2008.